I'm so excited to have everyone here, all of our family, friends, city dignitaries, clergy. Thank you all for coming out. Season's greetings. This year marks a very special year for us. Every year we hold our tree lighting, but today we are here in this beautiful plaza, Unity Plaza, which represents our past and present history, right on this wall here. So, before we get started, I do want to remind everybody of the reason that we are here today. So if I could have Pastor Howard please come up with the invocation before we get started. Thank you.
Let's pray. I thank you, our Father and our God, we thank you for this time and this gathering. We thank you, God, for the leadership of this city. We thank you for the citizens of East Chicago. We would ask, God, that you would bless everyone that passes through this city, that comes in and out of this city. Bless them and keep them safe. We thank you for what you're doing, even in this time. We thank you for who you are in our lives and how you have impacted our lives and our family. We thank you for what you're going to do in the upcoming year. We ask it all in the matchless name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and thank God. I've been asked, for those of you who don't know me, I am Pastor Cedric Howard. I pastor the Goodwill Baptist Church, 5119 Indianapolis Boulevard. I've been there for about 12 years now. Recently, I'm sure you all have heard, we sit directly across the street from Kosciuszko Park. We've been at that location for about 25 years. So for 25 years, Mr. Kosciuszko has literally watched over us. He has watched our going and our coming for over 25 years. He has watched us day in and day out. And I've pledged to the mayor that whenever he makes it back, we're going to reciprocate what he's been doing for us in the coming years. So I'm glad to be here tonight. I want to thank the mayor and his staff for allowing me to take part of this. So I'm here to talk about the reason for the season. Most of us, I'm sure all of us, are aware of why we celebrate Christmas. We celebrate Christmas to commemorate the birth of Jesus the Christ. And often I wonder, a couple years ago, I thought about, what would Jesus do if he was here on December 25th? What would he do? How would he celebrate his birth? What would he do? And I thought about how Jesus was born. The Bible talks about Jesus being born in a manger. Jesus' coming was really to redeem man back to the Father. So he had to be born, and he came, and he was born in a manger. And I believe that him being born was really a symbol for those of us who are downtrodden, who don't have any hope. Him being born where he was born was to let us know that you can rise to the occasion in any situation that you're in. Jesus was literally born in a trough. He was born in a barn. It was literally a feeding trough filled with hay. He was born in the lowest situation, but as we know, he rose to the top. And so when I think about Christmas on the 25th of December and this season, to me, I think about again, what would Jesus do on his birthday? And I am certain that Jesus would not accept any gifts from any of us. I'm certain that Jesus wouldn't accept any accolades or anything like that. He wouldn't have a party. He wouldn't turn up like we do for 3 days. But I believe that Jesus would celebrate his birthday by giving back to people who are less fortunate than we are. His birthday, his birth, and this season should be all about giving back and inspiring people to let them know that they can have hope. And I believe, and I believe that this is what Jesus would want us to do. A couple years ago, about 25 years ago, I was coming out of a mall. I used to be one of those people who would shop on Christmas Eve and get upset that the stores didn't have anything left. I was coming out of a major mall in South Carolina, there were four lanes coming out of the mall, four lanes coming in, real big mall, and there was a young man standing in the medium with a sign that said, I will work, I will do anything to be able to buy something for my children for Christmas. And I was about 10 cars back in the line. We were waiting for the light to change. And what struck me about the scene was not the young man who was standing in the medium. He was healthy looking, looked like he was about 30 years old. But what struck me about the scene was when I was able to look through the cars and to see people who wouldn't even look at this young man, wouldn't even recognize him. This young man was so close, he could literally just touch their car. But they wouldn't even acknowledge the young man. And that touched my heart because this is the kind of world that we live in. We live in a world now to where we don't even see people who are less fortunate than we are. We turn a blind eye to them. And so when the light changed, and I'm clothing, when the light changed, the only thing I had, I just left the mall, the only thing I had was a $100 bill. And I rolled up to the young man and I stopped, people start blowing the horn because they wanted to go through. I rolled the window down, I took the $100 and I handed it out. I said, here, young man, I said, this is all I have. I hope this helps. He said, no, sir. He said, I don't want a handout. I said, well, I don't have a job to give you. This is all I have. He said, no, sir, I don't want a handout. Thank you very much. God bless you. And so that spoke volumes to me, how there are people that during this season, there are people who really need help, you all. And so if you can do anything this year as it relates to commemorating the birth of Jesus Christ, do for someone else that's less fortunate than you are. And so when I see all of these lights go up, these lights are about hope for people. We're living in a city now where we have this great mayor and his staff beautifying this place, giving hope to people. They're at the parks, they're revitalizing the parks, the jobs that are coming in. This is what it's all about, you all. It's about touching people and giving them a sense of hope. Can you do me one favor, and I'm gonna put this mic down. Would you just look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, please spread love and hope this season. God bless you. Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Howard. Amen. Okay, is everybody ready? Okay, next up we have our Honorable Mayor, Anthony Copeland.
You know, I'm a little teary-eyed. I'm a little touched. Pastor, you hit a nerve. Because I look out here, I see the little people, I call them the young folks, and I see they are our future. I tell people we are a city of hope and progress. Because when you give up hope, then that's truly when you've lost. So I look into this crowd and I see that hope embedded in them. Pastor, you're right. This is the year or the time of year we commemorate the birth of our Christ. But again, he is within all of us. I tell people, this city has been truly blessed. Every morning when I get up, I look in this one corner window, and first I thank him for allowing me to see the light of a new day. Amen. Then I simply say, Lord, let your will be done. Then the last thing I ask him for the wisdom that I may lead this city into a beautiful place. And he has granted me so many blessings that financially this city is healthy. Spiritually, you can see this city getting healthier and healthier. So to all of the clergy out here, I tell you, thank you for your blessings. For when I first became mayor, you prayed over this administration, and I can tell you prayer works because I have been able to get blessings every day. But we're here to light this tree, y'all. We're here to light this tree. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right. There we go. Hey, that's what the kids call putting a little bling in it.
I have failed until a strong partnership with this council. I send stuff over there. They either voted up, voted down, but they also make sure that what I send over there is good before they let it go forward. I'm going to ask Council President Lenny Franciscus. I know I'm going to put you on the spot, but please come up and say a few words.
And just keep it short. I know everybody's a little chilly. I just want to wish everybody happy holidays. Merry Christmas to them and their families. So God bless you guys.
All right, we're going to go ahead with the program. We have quite a few music selections here. First off, we have Ramia McCoy, our beautiful 8-year-old with Silent Night.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round young virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender. There in my sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
Okay, next up we have Dr. Kendricks and the All City Choir. Please give it up for Dr. Kendricks.
All right.
And the All City Choir.
To our Honorable Mayor Copeland and staff here, thank you all for inviting us to be a part of Christmas tree lighting. We would like to introduce for the first time, if I can have your attention, please. Thank you so much. This wonderful choir that's come together to represent the unity of our city, to represent families, to represent different cultures, coming together to make a perfect blend. And we have a few selections that we're gonna do tonight. Please receive our East Chicago Unity Holiday Choir of Hope.
It's perfect for the city of hope and progress.
You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list, he's checking it twice, he's gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows when you're awake,
he knows when you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake. You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping.
Yeah.
He knows when you're awake. He knows when you've been bad or good.
So good for goodness sake. You better watch out. You better not cry.
You better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's making it.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's checking it twice.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's gonna find out.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Naughty or nice.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa Claus is coming.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's coming to town.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa Claus is coming.
Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. To town.
I want y'all to receive a young man that came out of Central High School, Tommy Billups, in his own way.
All right, as they were talking, I heard them talking about hope. So this song's gonna be about hope.
Don't want the fame nor the fortune. I don't want a fancy car nor expensive rent. You can have the gold and the diamonds, your expensive properties and your mansion. None of these things to me are important, as long as I have hope for tomorrow. So I'll hope through the night, hope for my dream, hope for the light, my destiny. Give hope through these strings, hope will I sing to you. Hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. Said I gotta have hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. People are dying every day. Drugs, sex, and violence is all the media ever displays. There are no mothers. Where are our fathers? The game has our sisters. The streets have our brothers. But we gotta get them back. So I'll hope through the night. Hope for my dream, hope for the light, my destiny. Give hope through these strings, hope will I sing to you. Oh, hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. Said I gotta have hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. Said I got hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. Hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. So I'll hope through the night, hope for my dream, hope for the light, my destiny. Give hope through these strings, hope will I sing to you. Oh. hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. Hope for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow.
Thank you. Alright, so we're going to start in 1 minute. So if you want to get a little closer, see the tricks. These tricks are cool. They've been handed down generations in my family because nobody wanted them. My grandfather was an artist. My great-grandfather was an artist. I don't have a real job either. Let me ask some questions, you guys. How many of you have seen a real magic show before? Raise your hand if you've seen one.
Okay, let me ask this question. How many of you guys want to help me? Is there anybody there who wants to help? A lot of people. Okay, put your hands down. If you really want to help me with a trick, this is what I look for. I look for people who are paying attention. I look for people who are being polite. That means keeping your hands to yourself. And I look for people who are having fun. You ready to have some fun?
Yeah!
All right, well, my name is Tomas. I kind of have a long name. I'm Tomas Gonzuelos San Miguel de Agosto Martinez Garcia Pamplona Medina, but for short, people just call me T. And that's my name. My father is Hispanic. My mom is Rick Moranis. People think I look like the guy who shrunk the kids, which we don't want to get into therapy. All right, so firstly, I'd like to point out, and secondly, I would like to say this. Thirdly, I'd like to say a few small words of, at, to, know, it, I, me, or, these are small words. Fourthly, I'd like to look at it this way. Fifthly, I'd like to tell you guys a joke. What do you call a guy with a rubber toe? Roberto? Zing. And then lastly, I'd like to show you guys a magic trick. You ready for a magic trick?
Yeah!
All right. This is called the Rope of Mystery. Everybody has to go, ooh. Thank you for the fabricated enthusiasm. I have a long piece of rope. Everybody say, go. Look at this. The ends come off the rope. And then now, over here, I've got a rope with no ends. People say, hey, I know where the ends are. They're over here. These are the jokes. And then I take the ends, they go on the loop, and now with the face of an angel, the hands of a god, and the heart of a rat, they go right back on. Now, as I wait for the thunderous applause to finally subside, people come up to me and they say, Tomas, can you do the trick where you cut the rope with scissors? Have you ever seen that trick? Okay, I don't have any scissors on me, but I can improvise. Now, if I untie the knot, you can see that I have two. Magic fans, how should I fix the rope? Should I do it the easy way or the hard way? All right, hard way involves, well, the easy way because I tie it back together. But also, there's a little bit of magic, so all I have to do is pause for the cause, and now voila, which is French for voila, they go right back together. Now watch the ends and watch the middle. Do you guys see the middle? Okay, they're going to do the 1-2 switcheroo. This goes from here across the hollow core over to here. Now, this one, due to lack of technical variety, happens the same way. Every once in a while, people think that I'm using fake, phony magic rope that you can get at, like, a magic novelty manufacturing company, like Fun Incorporated at 333 Alice Street in Wheeling, Illinois. But no, this happens to be real rope. Can I show you guys my skills portion of the show?
Yeah!
All right, here we go. I always had problems tying knots. Who has problems tying their shoes? Yeah, totally appreciate that. Look, always had problems. Look, it goes through the loop, you know? But the knot would never stay. I'd even try to give it one of these crazy knots. Those would not stick either. I found that I was pretty good for a kid with glasses at doing a one-handed knot. So can I get a little drum roll for this? Here we go, friends. This is my one-handed knot. Ooh. Now, a lot of people ask me to do that twice, so I'll save you guys the trouble of asking. Give me another drum roll, you guys. Here we go. I'd like to dedicate this one to all my baby's mamas. This is my one-handed knot. And I know that you've been holding back all the clapping. I guess now's the time you can let out the applause, you guys. Yeah. So that's kind of how my show works. I do some jokes. If you don't like the jokes, it's all right. I do tricks. If you don't like the tricks, I do more jokes, some more tricks, some more jokes. And then by the time you figure that out, I'm out of here. Are you ready for my next trick?
Yeah!
Would you guys like to see my best trick?
Yeah!
All right, normally I save my best trick for the end of my show, but nobody sticks around to the end of my show, so I'm gonna do my best trick right now. And my best trick is with this, can I dedicate this one?
Yeah.
I'd like to dedicate this trick to my next door neighbor, the lady. She's an old bag. All right, here's the bag, here's the bottle. Watch the bottle go inside the bag. Boys and girls, I need you to stick your hand out. Wiggle your fingers, all right? Is everybody wiggling it? Let me see you wiggle it. Just a little bit. I wanna see you wiggle it. Just a little bit. And then I reach inside the bag. Remember the bottle? Look at this, it's changed into a Coca-Cola bottle. Whoa, now the hard part of that trick is making it change back. It goes back inside. This time I'll throw a smoke bomb. Smoke bomb! And then I reach inside the bag and look, it's back. Was that not some straight up Chris Angel right there? You guys, you seem underwhelmed. You're not impressed. Should I do it again? Let me do the trick again until you like it. Look, it goes inside the bag. This time we wiggle the fingers just like before, you guys. I reach inside, look at this, changes back into the bottle of Coca-Cola. And now this time we gotta throw a smoke bomb, everybody. Smoke bomb! And then I reach back inside and look, it's back. Thank you, one kid, two people. It's all right, I heard somebody say that I have two bottles in here. Just out of curiosity, who thinks that I have two bottles in here? All right, everybody, now you're gonna feel real silly, put your hands down. You're gonna feel real silly, real silly. Ready? Apology accepted. All right, you know what? The last time I saw this trick, I forgot to clap too. Let's move on, I've got more tricks. Oh, nice, you thought you got ripped off and then you got a really good magic trick. So, for my next trick here, I need to bring up somebody to help me out with my magic show. It's a lot of fun being our participant in the magic show. Let's see, how about this nice little girl right there, you with the jacket on, come on up this way, everybody clap her, watch your step, come over this way, here she comes. Hi, what's your name? Janiyah's name is Janiyah. All right, Janiyah, I have a bag. Everybody has to go, ooh. Thank you for the fabricated enthusiasm. Now, this is not just any bag. This is the magic bag. After all, it's a magical time of year. You gotta ask me, how magic?
How magic?
Let me tell you how magic this bag is. This bag, most bags have two sides, right? Right, this one, this bag. Remember, there's the red side and there's the orange side. This bag, believe it or not, magic fans, this one is the magic bag and it has three. Whoa, right? I do this one in the mirror and I just laugh. It's a lot of fun. Now, this is not just any magic bag. You gotta say, how magic?
How magic?
So magic, this bag does not have two. It does not have three. Bet, it has, look at that, four sides. Was that at thebomb.com? That was a great trick right there. Now, this is not just any magic bag, you guys. This happens to be the special magic bag. How magic?
How magic?
Funny you should ask, it's so magic. Look at this, it's got five sides, and this one's extra special because it has a zippered compartment. Inside the zippered compartment, I have the prop for the magic trick, which is a red, seasonally appropriate scarf. Okay, Zanaya. Hi, Glitter Bear. Okay, you ready?
Yes, mister.
All right. Here we go. I want you to take this and wave it high in the air. Wave it high in the air. Okay, but not too much because it attracts weird attention. I'll take back the scarf. Now look. A lot of guys do this trick. They put the silk in the hand, but not me. No, the amazing Tomas. I am not of the status quo. I am an individual here today. And it's going to go not in my hand, but it goes inside the organic tunnel of mystery. Yes, it goes inside the organic tunnel of mystery. And then tonight, can you hold on to my wrist? Very good. Now the question for her is, why is this nice young lady holding onto my wrist when the silk is gone? Clap for Zanaya. Good job. Yay. Now we're going to bring it back. Zanaya, wave your hand in a mysterious fashion over my hand. Thanks, Poopsie Bear. And now we reach inside the organic tunnel of mystery and pull it out, and let's see if we did it. Look at that, we did it. Clap for my friend, she did a great job. Now this time, Zanaya, it's a little different, All right, this goes inside the organic tunnel of mystery. It goes all the way inside, and Zanaya, just like before, I want you to hold onto my wrist, please. Now she's holding onto the wrist, but this time, when it disappears, okay, hold the applause. This time it goes from the left to the right, stand up, sit down, fight. Everybody clap for Zanaya, she did a great job. Zanaya, ready for the big finish?
Yes, mister.
All right, big finish, here we go. This time it goes inside the organic tunnel of mystery, and it goes all the way in. But no, when I make it disappear, friends, it goes not up my sleeve. No, people think I like to use my sleeve. Zanaya, this time, but this one here, it's not gonna go up my sleeve, friend. It's gonna go all the way up Zanaya's sleeve. There you go. Now there's two ways to end this trick. The first way is with clapping, the other way is without clapping. Let's do it with clapping. Everybody let it out for my gal pal Zanaya. We're there, friend. She did a great job. Watch your step as you go all the way back. Zanaya,
find out who's nigh and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town.
it's that time of year where you let all your problems go. And you know, you just
shake it, baby. Shake it, baby. Ooh, do 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 do. Shake it, baby.
One, two, three.
Happy holidays!